thank you all for coming today. We come to remember the short life of Ventura Heiser and to comfort each other through a loss that seems beyond our understanding. We come to share memories and to remind ourselves that there is hope even through difficult times. I share these words from the book of Lamentations in the Old Testament, a time that was particularly difficult for these people. I know it's years ago, but it speaks to our world today as well. The writer says, "The thought of my suffering and homelessness is bitter beyond words. I will never forget this awful time as I grieve over my loss." He was very honest with his feelings. But then he says, yet I still dare to hope when I remember this. The unfailing love of the Lord never ends. By his mercies we have been kept from complete destruction. Great is his faithfulness. His mercies begin afresh each day. I say to myself, the Lord is my inheritance, therefore I will hope in him. Let's pray together. Father, it is difficult to come and work through the memories, the grief, the depth of feeling that we have here. But I pray as your word speaks to us, as you use this time to bring hope to us, God, I pray that your comfort would be found in this time. Even as the book of Lamentations says, yet I still dare to hope when I remember this. God, may we remember your unfailing love. May we remember your mercies. May we remember your faithfulness that is fresh each day. Lord, I pray that we would get a sense of your presence among us here. Father, speak to us. May your mercy, your grace, your comfort be upon us now as we share this time together in Christ's name. Amen.
Like to ride, drive a rain. Yeah, when
5 months, there were a lot of memories made, a lot of pictures taken. And we want to share that this morning because they bring great joy to look back. Joy and pain sometimes walk together in the road of life. So let's share some memories. I know Grandma Amy is going to share first this morning, just reflecting upon the real blessing we have had in Ventura.
We want to thank everybody for coming out today to share in the beautiful life of Ventura. We were not able to have him for very long, but he was an absolute joy for us in the 5 sweet months that he was here. And I wanted to share some of the memories that that I had with him. Savannah's a new mother and a phenomenal mother. But I was also her backup whenever it came to the baby. When Ventura was born, he came out and he looked around at everything. He could track you. He could literally see people. He looked at every single person in the delivery room. And people said that it was impossible, but it was so true. He took in every single thing that he saw. He looked at everything around him. He had to be, if we had baby blinders, that probably would have been the best, because he would only, if he saw anything in his eyesight, he would stay away. He wanted to take in every single thing that he had, that he could. I know that he would have been somebody that would go out and explore and run into the other backyards and just be a terror on wheels for his parents. He was a voracious eater. He would eat every bottle, every ounce of every bottle that was ever put in front of him. I've never seen a child eat that much and for that great. He was also a phenomenal burper. Now, all you had to do was, even at his little infant, you would just pick him up, sit him in a sitting position, and he would burp automatically. It was the most unique thing that I have ever seen in my entire life. He was absolutely incredible. I remember one time when we were having problems when he was a little bit under the weather, and he was not interested in taking his bottle when he was sick. I remember putting on Hill Street Blues, and every single time Hill Street Blues was on, he would just sit and stare at Hill Street Blues while we were watching TV and we were feeding him. He was such an incredible baby, and we loved him so much. Savannah's going to speak next and share her memories, but we would also like, the microphone is open to anyone that wants to come up and share their memories about Ventura as well. Savannah?
I'm Caitlin. I was Ventura's aunt. I am Ventura's aunt. And this is Savannah's speech for Ventura and Julian's as well. My beautiful, sweet baby boy. Words can't even begin to describe how much your dad and I miss you. You were such a blessing, and we are beyond grateful for the time we had with you.
We were taken too young and way too soon. Everything we had planned is gone. Your dad and I wanted nothing more than to see you grow up. I'm sorry we can't be there for that. But you have family with you, and that makes your dad and I feel a little better that you're safe and in good hands. It will seem like forever until we're with you again. Until then, we will hold you in our... Until then, we will hold you in our memory and our hearts forever. I know you're watching over us, telling us not to be sad and that you're happy, but we just miss you so much. Your laugh filled us with joy. We love speaking, or we love seeing you smile or hearing you try and speak to us. You always beamed with excitement when you saw me or your dad. We couldn't have asked for a better son. You're the best thing that ever happened to the both of us, and we just love you so much. You have forever impacted our lives, and we will always be your parents.
Is there anyone else who would like to say something, share a memory? Just come on up, it's fine.
Hello, I'm Sandra. I'm Julian's aunt, mother. I've raised him since he was four. We got to enjoy the beautiful baby Ventura for just a few months, and we didn't get to see him as much as we would have loved to because of this pandemic. But the times that we did see him and we held him were just perfect. Nothing could be more perfect than this beautiful child. Julian and Savannah were very young parents, but watching them with little Ventura was just amazing. You could see the love in their eyes. You could see that baby's love for them as well. The times that I held him, just sweet, sweet smile, eye contact, just alert. He is going to be missed, but in our hearts forever. Lord, we don't know why he was taken so soon, but thank you for letting us enjoy him for those 5 months that we had, our precious baby. And for those of you who would like to join, this is Joanne's sister, Joanne. And we'd like to say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death. Amen. We love you, Julian and Savannah. We're here for you. Little Ventura, you're in our hearts forever.
Anyone else?
I wrote something a little bit short for Ventura, but I wanted to come up here and say my goodbyes to him. First, I just wanted to say that Julian and Savannah, I've known Savannah my whole life, obviously, because she's my sister, and she's always been my best friend. We've always been so close, and we got pregnant together, basically, and we were gonna have babies together. It was so ideal, and I was like, oh great, I don't have to give Annalise a sibling because she has this cousin that she's gonna be so close to.
going to all work out so great. And they were just such amazing parents, and like, no parent deserves to lose their child, but they did it, especially. They loved him so much, and I know that he changed their lives. And I wish he was still here. But I know that he's up there with so many of our family members and so many of Julian's family members. And I just wanted to talk about some memories that I had with him about, like, when Savannah would get really, really bored, she would always like put Ventura in this blue and gray teddy bear outfit, and she would walk him around the house while Julian was at work and be like, look at Ventura, look at Ventura, just because she got bored in this cute little teddy bear outfit. And like, I know he was hot and uncomfortable in that outfit, but like, he looked adorable, so it was worth it. And Ventura and I, actually, I watched him, I think, only once by myself. So I did see him a lot, but I only got that time with him alone. And in that time, it was really short, but it was amazing. I was able to get him laughing on camera. And I, of course, you know, like, had to pull out all the weird, goofy Snapchat filters, which I'm sure y'all will see in the pictures and videos and everything. So yeah, that was mostly me. But I'm happy that we're all here together, and I'm always here for you, Savannah. You know that, and I love you so much. And you were the most amazing mother, and you were going to be a mother again. And you're always Ventura's mom, and he loves you. He's looking down on all of us right now, and he wants us all to use this day to mourn, but to move on and cherish him from now on instead of grieve when we think about him. And so that's what I'm gonna do, and I hope everybody else does that as well, because these memories are just so important to cherish and to just appreciate instead of just, you know, look at to wish that we had more. So that's all I wanted to say, but thank you.
Thank you all for sharing those memories, powerful words. Julian and Savannah, loved the little thing you wrote here, dear Ventura, powerful and heartfelt in the words you share here as well. Your grief is real, and to have family with you here is a wonderful thing as they walk through this part of your life journey and support you in it. And of all the titles or names given to God, the one that speaks to us during a time like this is the title or name Father. In fact, as we said the Lord's Prayer together, it began, Our Father, Our Father. The very concept of God carries with it some pretty big thoughts, like Creator, Sovereign of the Universe, King, Eternal One, Powerful, Righteous Judge. But when you call him Father, you relate to him in such a way that is different than any other way that we try to understand God and how he works and how he reveals himself to us. A father is supposed to love, care, protect, and provide for his children. A father is there when a child can't feed themselves or can't do even the simplest of things. A father is there when a child learns to walk, talk, or whatever. Father or mother, for that matter, is there when a child cries, smiles, and inevitably throws that temper tantrum that you go, ah, this is going to be a long, long night. It's times like these that we call upon God and we say, Our Father. The Bible is full of references to how God relates to us as a father. He created us. He knows us better than we know ourselves. He cares for us. He protects us. He leads us along the road of life. He sees what we struggle with. He knows our pain. He understands. He comforts us in our distress, and he promises a better future than anything this world has to offer. And yet many times that's difficult to understand. Psalm 91 says this: those who live in the shelter of the Most High will find rest in the shadow of the Almighty. This I declare of the Lord: he alone is my refuge, my place of safety. He is my God, and I am trusting him. For he will rescue you from every trap and protect you from the fatal plague. He will shield you with his wings. He will shelter you with his feathers. Get this imagery of a mother hen bringing the chicks in. His faithful promises are your armor and your protection. Later on in that same psalm, it says, the Lord says, I will rescue those who love me. I will protect those who trust in my name. When they call on me, I will answer. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. That's the love of a father that we turn to in difficult times like this. One of the greatest attributes of a father is love. I've already heard great expressions of both motherly and fatherly love from Julian and Savannah. But listen to the love of the Father, our God, expressed to us in Christ, his Son, our Savior. In Romans chapter 8, the question is asked, what can we say about such wonderful things as these? If God is for us, who could ever be against us? God did not spare even his own Son, but gave him up for us all. Won't God, who gave us Christ, also give us everything else? That passage ends with these great words of hope and comfort. I'm convinced that nothing can ever separate us from his love. Death can't. That's an important thing to remember. Death can't separate us from the love of God. Death draws us closer into the love of God in a way that we try to understand here. The angels can't, the demons can't, our fears for tomorrow or today, our worries about tomorrow, and even the power of hell can't keep God's love away from us. Whether we are high above the sky or in the deepest ocean, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus, our Lord. It's the powerful love of God, the Father, who is with us. Family, friends, there are many things we do not understand in this world. And what we struggle with right now is the question of why God would allow a little five-month-old boy to pass from this earth. It leaves us with profound grief and a sorrow that seems unmatched by anything we have ever gone through. Yes, tears, wonder, unbelief, and even anger. It's all very real. But so is the truth of God's word to us. And while we might not understand all these things about God, it doesn't change who he is and what he has promised to those who turn to him for help, for comfort, for direction, as we go on from here. And we should not overlook the very fact that God gave his own son to die, not because of anything he had done or anything he deserved, but because God saw a much greater battle going on in this world. And he knew that the only way to make that right for all of us was to defeat the enemy, sin, and provide a way for each and every one of us to be drawn close to the Father who created us, who loves us more than anything we can ever imagine. John 3:16, a verse that many, many people, whether they're churchgoers or followers of Christ or whatever, have heard before. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever would believe in him, whoever would turn and trust in him, would not perish. Certainly we all die on this earth, but he's talking about eternal life, but would live eternally. That's what we can celebrate today. That's what we can have hope in for Ventura, passing from one life to an eternal life, even with the things that we don't understand about that. God didn't give his son to condemn the world, but to save the world. And we need to remember that together. I believe that little Ventura has been welcomed into the presence of God, the one who ultimately created him, knew him before the beginning of time, the one we call our Father in heaven. And that should bring us a great deal of comfort Even while our pain and grief is upon us, we need to trust God for that, to give it to Him, and to allow His Spirit to comfort and shelter us. The prophet Isaiah, again in the Old Testament, says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart. He will keep you in perfect peace, all those who trust in Him." Trust in the Lord always, for the Lord God is our eternal rock. Let's pray together. Father, I would ask that you would help us to trust, because it's hard. You would help us to find some comfort in this, because it is so difficult. Our grief is real, Father, and we're struggling with that. But I pray that your presence would be upon us, and somehow, even in your grace, we would be able to trust. We would be able to turn to you and know that you care, and know that you love, and know that you will lead us through this. So, Father, may your goodness be upon us now, that we can know you are the Father who cares and comforts us in this great time of need. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. We're going to hear another song, and as the song is played, those pictures will be on the screen once again. Just use those to reflect upon the great memories that we share together.
Ooh.
close with one of the psalms that has touched my life many times as I reflect upon our struggle with questions, the why question, the wonder question of life. Psalm 139, a great psalm that was written by a man named David, wrote many of the psalms. He's reflecting upon his own life. He says, if I ride in the wings of the morning, if I dwell by the farthest oceans, wherever I am, your hand will guide me and your strength will support me. I could ask the darkness to hide me and the light around me to become night, as if he was hiding from God. But he says, but even then, I can't hide from you. To you, the night shines as bright as day. Darkness and light are both alike to you. And then he says this, you made all the delicate inner parts of my body and knit me together in my mother's womb. Thank you for making me so wonderfully complex. Your workmanship is marvelous, and how well I know it. You watched me as I was being formed in utter seclusion, as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. How precious are your thoughts about me, O God. They are innumerable. I can't even count them. They outnumber the grains of sand, and when I wake up in the morning, you are with me. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for your love. Thank you that we can call you Father. While we recognize you are the Creator, the Redeemer, the Sustainer, and all those other names that the Bible uses to describe you, what speaks to us now is that you are a Father who loves us. So, Father, I pray that your grace and mercy would be with us. I pray especially, God, that you would just bring your comfort, your special hand of grace upon Julian and Savannah and the family. Say, draw together. And, well, God, we're tempted many times to struggle with that question of why. For some reason that we don't even know, you have not chosen to answer that. But you have asked us to trust you. So, Father, we give ourselves to you for that. Even what little we might know of you, what little we might understand about who you are and how you operate, Father, I pray that with that we would turn to you and know that all will be well in your time and in your way. So guide us in that now as we go in your peace and to your glory. In Christ's name, amen. Thank you once again for being here. Family is let out, and then you will be dismissed now.